Joining us now is Heidi Gnall. Heidi is the founder and previous CEO of, get this, the largest pet care franchise company in the world. After dealing with some adversity early in her life, she started the business in 2000 with one Denver Camp Bow Wow. One. Eventually building the company, get this, into a $100 million business with more than 200 franchises in the U.S. and Canada, hitting the Inc. magazine's 5,000 list 5 years in a row. I mean, think about this. You start with one idea and one little store in Denver, and you grow it to a $100 million business. Is that not the American way? I don't think Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez quite grasped this concept. I mean, he starts with one store. I mean, it's like the American dream. After selling Camp Bow Wow a few years ago, Heidi dedicated herself to giving back. She was elected statewide to the Board of Regents of the University of Colorado, a Buffalo, and was on several other boards focusing on stuff. And in 2015, she was appointed by the Gov of Colorado to the School Safety and Youth in Crisis Committee. So she's a pretty neat lady. She's also on the board of the Job Creators Network. And she has some information on the National Women's Coalition. Quite the resume you have there, Heidi.
Oh, thank you, John. Thanks for having me this morning.
So, okay, before we get into taxes and policies and the economic resurgence that the president is talking about based on the tax cuts and everything else, can you just share with us? I mean, look, it's fascinating for people to think, okay, you had this idea and you started Club Bow Wow, one store in Denver. And then all of a sudden, it's a $100 million company. How did you do that?
It took a few years, but it was a great adventure. I had a couple dogs, and this was back in the early 90s, and I couldn't leave them at the typical kennels, the old style with the chain link and the concrete. And so my first husband and I thought, you know, we should create a really cool place for dogs where people don't have to feel guilty and it's fun and we don't mind leaving them there. So we came up with the idea for Camp Bow Wow, which was doggy daycare and overnight boarding, but the overnight boarding, they could play all day. And wrote up the business plan, but we were in our early 20s and didn't have a lot of money and maxed out on student loan debt. But we decided we were still going to try it. And about 6 months into that was my husband's 25th birthday. And my family had run into an old family friend of ours that was a United Airlines pilot. And he was doing air shows with an old biplane, a 1943 Stearman, and encouraged my dad to come down and he would take him for a ride. And my dad decided to surprise my my husband, and they did all the stunts, and the plane crashed into the ground right in front of my parents, and my husband was killed,
oh my goodness,
as well as the pilot.
Oh, heavens.
So my life changed pretty at that point, and I put the business plan on the back burner and I got a settlement from the plane crash of about $1 million, managed to mess that up over the next few years, and ended up a single mom with about 80 grand left of the $1 million about 5 years later. And my little brother came to me and said, let's start Camp Bow Wow. And that's how we launched on that journey.
I'm so sorry for your loss, Heidi.
Thank you.
I know it was a long time ago, but I mean, it's just, you can't even imagine telling that story now. All right, so you started one store. But, you know, this is like the American dream, right? You start with one location and you build it to a $100 million business. Like, just give us the first three steps of how that happened.
lots of dogs, and lots of tenacity. I really believed in the idea, and it was so fun to work on. I mean, how much fun can you have hanging out with, you know, 50 to 100 dogs every day? But we had to convince the veterinarians that this was a good idea because they were our referral source. And so I spent a lot of time. I came out of pharmaceutical sales, and I applied the same theory and just went around to veterinarians and handed out information. And they thought we were crazy, that the dogs would never like playing together. But I don't know why they didn't. Social animals, and they love hanging out with each other. And then I took my little girl with me. She was four at the time, and we went to the park every night and handed out dog bones or dog biscuits to, you know, all the folks in the park with a flyer for a free day at camp. And things kind of took off, and we opened a second location, and then one of my clients was in franchising and said, you should franchise this. And I'm like, what? I don't know anything about franchising. So I went to the International Franchise Association meeting and got some great mentors and just started, you know, doing the work to sell franchises, and things took off. about 2 years into it, we were featured on the cover of America Online as the next great franchise, back when AOL was like everybody was on the, that was the internet basically for everybody. And we got over 3,000 franchise sales leads from that one day alone. And that was really the turning point for Camp Bow Wow.
Wow, Heidi, what a tremendous story. And building this to a $100 million company, starting with one location and an idea, borrowing the money, handing out flyers at a park with your daughter. I mean, this is the American dream. I mean, that's the entrepreneurial spirit that everyone would love to have and have the opportunity to do that. You had the idea and implemented, also worked through tremendous adversity personally. I mean, I could only imagine that tragic event that you mentioned with your daughter, just so horrible, but you were able to get this done, and I congratulate you for that. Heidi, the president's tax cut is now coming into play for people, right? They saw more money in their paycheck through the last 10 months, but now they're starting to do their taxes and they're starting to see the savings and they're starting to see the difference in their companies because they can take that money like I have and invest it in new equipment, raise for their employees. How much of an impact is the Trump tax cut, do you think, Heidi, having on small businesses, which right now are the engine driving the American economic resurgence?
Oh, I think it's a huge part of it. And I'm so excited about some of the changes that have been happening there and his policies and tax cuts and lower regulation. I think that's a big part of it. But at the end of the day, we really have to hand it to small businesses and the job creators around the country for taking what's happening politically and transforming it into what's happening on the ground with more jobs and more raises and, you know, more economic growth. It's because they feel confident and they know that we're doing the right things policy-wise to free up entrepreneurs and small business owners to do what they do best, and that's create jobs, which is why I love being part of Job Creators Network. It's been a great experience, and it's really important.
Tell me a little bit about, from new business owners and small businesses, people that you've talked to, because I know you're now advising a lot of entrepreneurs and small business owners. Tell me about what some of their reaction has been to the tax cut plan and how that's been working for them.
Well, I think the biggest thing is they breathe a sigh of relief, like, oh my gosh, we have a business person in Washington, D.C. They get it. They get what we're going through. They're doing the right things in D.C. for a change around small businesses and entrepreneurship. And I think small business owners feel more confident hiring more people, investing in more, you know, projects and new initiatives. I mean, shoot, I'm starting a new business. I had no plans on doing that, you know, 4 or 5 years ago, but I'm so excited about the economy and what's going on. I want to dip my toe back in, and I think a lot of people have that sentiment.
You know, Heidi, wages are growing at their fastest pace in a decade. We've seen that with the job numbers, Heidi, that have come out. And the unemployment rate is basically at a 50-year low. Economic growth is going to come in above 3% for the first time for the year since 2005. Entrepreneurship is exploding right now. This administration has tackled a number of things, including high tax rates, government red tape, and things of that nature. Here's the thing. If you're talking to a small business owner today and the Trump economy comes up, deregulation and the tax cut plan, well, what is your message to entrepreneurs and small business owners out there now?
I say to get on the roller coaster of starting a business. It's a big adventure, but it's so fun and it's so empowering. And it's, you know, what gets me up every day and excited, because you're really making a difference. You're giving people a hand up, not a handout. And I think that's the biggest shift in our mindset. And it's so disappointing that socialism is getting popular again among young people. I see it as a regent at the University of Colorado, and I'm shocked that they have this view, and that Alexandria is spreading the word that this is how America should be. It's everything that we think America, or that people believe shouldn't be America. And I think the general public gets it. We just have to get through to our young people and tell stories about, you know, what socialism has done over the years and what the beauty of free markets and the reason poverty is so low globally and literacy is much higher is because of America's grand experiment, and that's free markets.
You're on the John Fredericks Radio Network, Trucking the Truth Across America. We're with Heidi Ganahl. She is an entrepreneur. She was the founder and the owner of Camp Bow Wow, starting with a single store after a tragedy in her own family, horrific tragedy that no one even can imagine, and growing into a $100 million business and a very popular, very profitable franchise that she basically started by herself with her brother. And it's kind of the American dream. Heidi, I want to talk a little bit about the women's entrepreneurship that you're heading. But first, I want to tell people, look, if you own a small business today, this Trump tax cut and the deregulations in the economy are such an opportunity for you to grow your business. If you don't know exactly what your taxes are going to be, whether you're an individual or you do own a company, go to taxcutswork.com. That's taxcutswork.com. And that's really all you need to have there, taxcutswork.com. You can plug everything in, and it's just an amazing opportunity to see the benefits of what this tax cut means and how you can take that money, grow your business, or just take it, go on vacation, or take it, put it in the bank in savings, or take it and pay off debt, or take it, do anything you want with it because it's yours instead of the government's, Heidi, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Tell us about your women entrepreneur effort. Tell us about that. How does that work?
Sure. So Job Creators Network started the National Women's Coalition, which I'm heading up along with Debbie Brown and here in Colorado, but it's national. And our idea is to really highlight great small business owners that are women and women moving up the corporate ladder that understand how detrimental overregulation, overtaxation is and how important it is to make sure that women have access to capital and credit and can start businesses. Because they really are, I think they're growing businesses or opening new businesses at twice the rate of men. So, gosh darn it, we want men to open businesses too and be entrepreneurs. But I think there's a special time and place right now to encourage women to really take the reins and drive entrepreneurship in this country. And that's what the National Women's Coalition is all about with Job Creators Network.
If people want to get involved in it, if there's a woman entrepreneur that wants more information or she would like to get involved in your organization through Job Creators Network, Heidi, how do they do that?
Just go to jobcreatorsnetwork.com/NWC or just Google the National Women's Coalition, NJCN, and you'll find a place to contact us. But it's great fun. We're out there, you know, speaking about entrepreneurship, talking about the importance of overregulation and overtaxation. It's important to stay focused on that so that things don't go back to the way they were and we keep making change and creating momentum for more women to be entrepreneurs.
And more information on what you're going to save with your taxes, go to taxcutswork.com, taxcutswork.com. Let me just share with our audience a few stats. 304,000 jobs were added in January, doubling expectations. Wages went up again in January, 3.2%. over January 2018. Unemployment remains at record low levels. 58% of newly created jobs last year were filled by women. We now have more women in the workforce than ever before in the history of the United States. More than 5 million jobs have been created since President Trump took office January 20, 2017. And as I said earlier, GDP is going to come in at over 3% the first time since 2005, and it's now 2019, and this will be for 2018. Why don't the liberals on the Democratic left understand, Heidi, in your view, this booming economy and how it has lifted so many people out of a tougher situation into a better one with good paying jobs? Why don't they seem to understand this?
Oh, I think they do, John. I think they're just trying to shift the narrative because it's such great news. I mean, we have a booming economy and things are going so well on that aspect that, you know, if they talk about that, then they're admitting that our policies work and free markets work and property rights work and individual rights work and entrepreneurship works. And I'm a strong believer in a smaller government, the proper role of government. And I think that's the shift is, do we want more government or less government? And in order to have less government, we need to give more control back to small business owners and entrepreneurs and let them do what's right for their businesses. They are going to drive job growth, which is really the hand up that people need and they're getting right now.
So if you're a Democrat, Heidi, in Congress, and you've signed on to the Green New Deal, which is driving the debt up by, I don't know, another $50 trillion and tax rates at 90% or whatever it is that they're trying to do, and somebody says to you, well, look at all what's happening now. Jobs created, wages up, unemployment down, almost 60% of new jobs going to women. GDP keeps rolling along. I mean, I'm like, how do you even come to this conclusion? Is just what I'm trying to get my arms around. Like, what would...
Well, I think they have to tap into people's emotion to shift their sentiment away from the success that we're having. And,
right.
You know, I tell people, instead of adding more regulation, I tell young people this a lot, instead of adding more regulation to business, vote with your dollar. You know, buy products and services from companies that you share values with and that you believe are good for the economy and good for your family. That's much more effective than adding more regulation. And this new Green Deal is a regulation boondoggle.
Go to taxcutswork.com. I mean, they want to eliminate, I don't know, airplanes and cars. It's just, it's a bizarre thing, but it's getting like serious play, which is amazing to me. I mean, I could see it if it was 2008 and, you know, we had 12% unemployment. I mean, I get it. People are looking for something different. They're looking for change. That at least would be a reason to have the debate. But right now with this economy as strong as it is, it's absolutely insane. Heidi, I want to thank you for your time today and for being with us. For more information, I want you to go to taxcutswork.com. That's taxcutswork.com. And you'll be able to get filled in there. Heidi Grinnell, you're a real tremendous success story in America. Thank you so much for being with us.
Oh, thank you for having me, John. Keep up the great work.
And if I had a dog, I would take it to Camp Bow Wow.
You know what? I don't know that you can in Virginia. The regulations are pretty heavy about opening doggy care facilities.
We need a cat. I'm a cat guy, Heidi, and I have a cat,
oh,
Sammy.
That's
and
okay.
I love
we
my
can
cat.
Start Camp Meow Meow next.
But you need Camp Meow Meow because, like, we travel with my son's baseball, and we never take the cat with us because you know how they are. They don't want to go in the car. They don't want to be out of their environment, all that stuff. And you can't get hotels where they take cats, so we got to get people over to feed him. And then he gets, you know, cats are very social, Heidi. They're very social. And people don't understand it because they're independent and they think, oh, they can be left alone. No, he gets so depressed when we leave and he sees those bags. But there's nowhere to take him, Heidi. There's no Camp Meow Meow.
Well, I'll put that on my to-do list. I'll try and solve that problem for you. But in the meantime, you know, you can put a webcam in your house and watch your kitty cat. And I think there's even ways you can talk to your cat while you're away now. So that's something to think about.
I'll look into that, Heidi. We need a Camp Meow Meow.